this time I would like to recognize the Atlantic Holstein Promotions Committee and for organizing the major shows in Atlantic Canada and today's Atlantic Dairy Championship Show. And we thank the directors on that committee that do all the work to put this together. I'd also like to thank the staff that work diligently behind and in front of the scenes here to make things happen. We've got Angela and Brian Masters managing the show. We have Jason Balma and John Raymond Dykstra doing the lineup and organizing. We have Alan Kennedy in the ring, acting as ringman. We've got Kara Irving here beside me doing the Premier Breeder and Exhibitor points. And all these people help to keep the show running and make it run smoothly, and we thank them for all their work throughout the day today. Well, I should also, I guess, mention my daughter Megan Vanderbloot, along with Alea Craswell, who are taking care of the ribbon duties today. Thank you. detention exhibitors in the barn. We are entering our first lineup of the junior three-year-old class. This will be followed by the intermediate champion class. It looks like we have all the cows from the intermediate champion class at ringside except for one. We need the second place milking yearling from Golden Flow. Second place milking yearling from Golden Flow to ringside, please. In this junior 3-year-old class, a nice pair of cows at the top that easily sort themselves to that point. First cow, I'm making the best mammary system, just has more bloom. And pop to her rear udder, just has more bloom all the way through, more width through that midsection of her rear udder today. She has a touch more vanation all the way through. And the cow is a little bit of a wider kind of square cut kind of cow with more depth of midsection to that rib area and more spring and pop to that rib today. I wouldn't give the second cow the advantage. She's just a touch longer, and the cow's maybe a little freer on that right rear hock, but just lacks that massiveness and that squareness of cut as the first place cow. The second place cow or the third place cow, she's a freer, a flowing cow. She's got she has more flex to that hock. She's more comfortable in her pastures. I like the way the thoroughs are sitting a little further forward today than the third place cow. She's a longer, cleaner, rawer kind of cow that has more quality to that mammary system today. The third big black cow is a big, massive, square cut cow. I just like to see her a little longer down the road. She's pretty fresh right today. She places over the cow next in her overall width and depth and squareness of cut, height and width at the top of the rear udder attachment today. The fourth cow over the fifth cow, she's a cleaner hock cow. She's a silkier hided, more open rib cow. She's got a nicer slant to her rib today. She's cleaner in that hock, has more flex to that hock. A really nice mammary system cow here in fifth, but I just like to clean her up all the way through, give her more breed character through the head, and more openness and drape to that rib to place any higher today. Thank you. Thank you, Judge Heath. Your placings in your junior 3-year-old class. The class sponsored by Crasdale Holsteins. Your class winner and best udder in class, Ring 115, Lelevan Baxter Fandango, exhibited by Burnendale Farm. Placing second and best bred and owned in the class, Ring 108, Berkentree Goldwyn Evelyn, exhibited by Berkentree Holsteins and Diamond Hill Farms. Placing third, Ring 114, Rokes owned Jasper Beyonce, exhibited by Brian Connor and Robert Flack. Placing fourth, Ring 110, Golden Flow Shuttle Gazelle, exhibited by Macbeth Farms. Placing fifth, Ring 113, Valleyville Shuttle Stella, exhibited by Cobblewood Holsteins and Straightside Holsteins. Reading beyond the program, once again, thank you to Crasdale Holsteins for sponsoring the class. Ring 108 was second, best bred and owned in class. Ring 109 was 8. 110 was 4. 111 was 7. Please note on Ring 111, the new owner is Ray J. LeClerc. Ring 112 did not show. Ring 113 was 5. 114 was 3rd. Ring 115, Lullaban Baxter Fandango, exhibited by Burnendale Farm, was your class winner and best udder in class. Ring 116 was 6. Currently entering the ring, we have the Parade of Champions for the Intermediate Champion of the show. We'd like to thank SureGain for sponsoring the champion. The Reserve Intermediate Champion, sponsored by Perennia. and honorable mention intermediate champions sponsored by Atlantic Holstein Promotions. So entering the ring, we have our first and second place Milking Yearlings, this class sponsored by Generations. Junior Twos, the class sponsored by Wheatsdale Holsteins. The Senior Twos, sponsored by Lindenor Holsteins. And the Junior Threes, sponsored by Crasdale Holsteins. As we enter another champion section of our show, we would remind exhibitors that if you do wish to have your animals pictured, Vicki Fletcher Photography is on site here today to picture animals, and Vicki is set up in her usual spot in the 4-H barn out behind the arena here. Thank you. three beautiful young cows that I pulled out here. Let's give them a good round of applause. And junior 2-year-olds, shortly fresh, a little over a month, needs to maybe clean up a bit, but a beautiful legged, high wide rear uttered young cow. Cow has great presence in the ring. The senior 2-year-old, another fine young cow with a beautiful mammary system. And then the junior 3, cow's got a lot of chest, a lot of rib, and a beautiful udder, lots of balance. I'm going to go out and tap my intermediate, reserve, and honorable mention, and then I'll come back and give you the reasons. 3 fine young cows. Just an awesome set of cows that fit very nicely together. I think the junior 3-year-old come to the forefront. She's ready. This cow's got that big rib, square cut, extreme balance, beautiful mammary system. She's just a little rawer, cleaner, more open today than the junior 2-year-old. Just more ready all the way through. The junior 2-year-old over the senior 2-year-old, I just feel she's more balanced. She's a little nicer through that crop area, through that front end area. And a cow that's more level on the udder floor, the senior 2's a little heavier in the front than the rear. Maybe when you get picking them apart, I just prefer the junior 2's mammary. She's a little wider at the top of the rear udder today, and maybe a little stronger in that pasture, but take nothing away from the senior 2. She's a long body, good udder, very stylish cow. Let's give him another good round of applause. 3 exciting young cows. Thank you. And those 3 exciting young cows are ring number 115, your intermediate champion, Lelevan Baxter Bandango, exhibited by Burnedale Firm. In reserve, ring number 95, Connerdale Atwood Knot, exhibited by Crasdale T&L Cattle Company and Ponderosa Holsteins. An honorable mention, ring 102, Big Maple Lou Lara, exhibited by Dunphy Holsteins. Your intermediate champions for the 2012 Atlantic Dairy Championship Show. And they will currently make their way into the photo area of those champions and be presented their honors by the sponsors. The sponsor of the intermediate champion is Suregain, and Mark Rose, representing Suregain, will present that award. We've got Dan Mosley from Perennia to give the award for the reserve intermediate, and we thank Atlantic Holstein Promotions for also sponsoring the honorable mention. Next class in the ring, we will move into the senior 3-year-old class. Senior 3s into the ring, please. This class sponsored by Burkertree Holsteins. And we again thank Blue Line New Holland for the best bred owned awards today. And the best udders in this class are sponsored by Fundy Vets. We'd also like to recognize Green Diamond, local John Deere dealers, as being the major sponsors of the shows in Atlantic Canada, or of Atlantic Holstein Promotions this year. And a thank you to Generations as well for sponsoring the programs.
Intermediate time, number 207.
Thank you.
here, just to talk somewhere.
Attention exhibitors in the barn, the senior three-year-olds are well into class here. So senior three-year-olds are well into class. We do not appear to have very many four-year-olds at ringside. So exhibitors, we need your four-year-olds to ringside, please, right away.
This is the side to sit on, isn't it?
Yeah,
extremely close placing here in the senior three-year-old class between the first two. Their mammary system, but I ended up went with the first Calabesta. She just has more bloom and more width all the way through the bottom to the top of the rear udder today. And it's extremely close in the mammary systems, and it's extremely close in the placing. As far as feet and legs, you can pick on both of them on their hind feet and legs, so that's kind of a wash. But the telling tale between these two cows is when I got behind them. This first cow just carries so much more width through that pin region, through that thoroughs and that hip area. She's got so much more spring and pop to her rib, and just more overall width and power and strength all the way through than the second cow. She also holds together her top line up through that front end a lot nicer in line. The second cow's a really pretty side profile cow, but like I said, when she got in line, she just didn't have that pop to the rib, the width through the rear end structure today to go over the first cow. The second cow over the third cow, handily today. She's just harder in that back part of the loin. She's just square in that shape to her mammary system. She easily places over the next cow in the drape to her rib and the balance and the style. The black cow over the white cow, just more length all the way through, length through the neck and the whole entire body. Just more lift to the front end, more comfortable moving cow today. A cow with more bloom than the white cow coming out next. This white cow in fourth over the fifth cow. I just feel she has more height and width and strength at the top of that rear udder, just a more desirable shape to that mammary system. Just a longer, deeper, more open rib, and cow just carries more balance all the way through. The black cow's a really silky cow here in fifth, but I just like to bring that more width and height at the top of that rear udder today and give her more pop to her rib to place any higher. Thank you. Your senior three-year-old class, sponsored by Burkentry Holsteins. Your class winner, ring number 119, also best owner in class, combination Golden Jewels, exhibited by Bernadale Firm. Placing second, best bred known in class, ring 118, Eastside Duplex Holly. Placing third, ring 121, Homestay Golden Purity, exhibited by Homestay Farms. Placing fourth, ring 120, Fierstein Lauren Perpetua, exhibited by Copperquid and Diamond Hill. And placing fifth, ring 123, Lalaban Spurt Flicka, exhibited by Copperquid, Luke McClellan, and Sandy Cole. Placing sixth, ring 122, I.D. Goldman Lulika. Reading down the program, 117 did not show. 118 was second and best owned in the class. Ring 119, combination Goldman and Jules, exhibited by Bernadale Firm, was your class winner and best other in class. 120 was fourth. 121 was third. 122 was sixth. And 123 was five. Now coming into the ring, we have the four-year-old class. Four-year-olds are entering the ring. This class sponsored by Bernadale Holsteins. Best bred and owned sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. And best other sponsored by Pure Holsteins.
taking a trip. I didn't believe anything. Yes, I am. I'm Randy Blodgett.
He was there, Randy Blodgett.
She gave a wink and a look.
Did she get an adoring look?
Yeah. Oh, I didn't put it on. I have it here. My email here. Give me your email. Hold on 2 seconds. Oh, what's special? Custom.
It's special zero.
It's custom.
Attention to the 5-year-olds in the barn. The 5-year-olds were looking for you at ringside. The 4-year-olds are into their first lineup, and we are in need of the 5-year-olds, please. At this time, I'd like to once again recognize our judge for the day. Our judge is Mr. Mike Heath from Westminster, Maryland. He breeds cows under the Heath prefix, although he says most of his cows are bred in partnership. Mike is a buyer and seller of cattle, semen, embryos, and dairy genetics in general. So basically a marketer and promoter of the breed. And of course, Mike had the honor of judging the Holstein show at World Dairy Expo last week, and we do welcome Mike to our show today and thank him for the fine job he's doing here in the ring today. We'd also once again like to recognize our overall sponsor of the show, our major sponsor, Green Diamond Equipment. And they've nicely put the John Deere tractors here in the ring for us, and we appreciate their sponsorship. Once again, as our show starts to, classes start to wind down, we do remind exhibitors to make their way out behind the arena here to see Vicki Fletcher Photography and have your animals photographed. And of course, you're going to want to have your animals photographed so that you can get your entries in the All-Atlantic competition. And the All-Atlantic nomination form was in the last edition of the Atlantic Holstein News. And we are looking to have all those All-Atlantic nominations in by Friday, November the 23rd. Just a reminder of that deadline that is just over a month away. A little closer deadline is November 2nd. November 2nd, we want the Atlantic Impact Cow of the Year nominations in. And we do encourage people to look around their barn or their community, province, and look for that cow that they think is deserving of recognition, that maybe she's a brood cow or has lots of longevity or started a great cow family, has lots of progeny out there, or maybe she's just done some great, great things herself. The cow needs to be bred and owned in Atlantic Canada and must be alive at the time of entry and must have a professional picture. Not necessarily this year's picture, but a picture. So we do encourage those nominations. We're now going to hand the mic over to Judge Heath for his reasons on the foregirls.
It's close in the Mannery systems, but I feel the first cow parades herself to the top. On the Mannery systems, the first cow's just a little leveler from front to rear on the Mannery system here today. And I like the way the front and the rear teats set a little nicer underneath the udder today than the second cow. And she's just smoother in the body wall on the Mammary system today than the second cow. But I would give the second cow the advantage of having more venation and quality to her udder. It's very close in the Mammary systems. The first cow just gets out there and moves a lot freer and easier than the second cow. She's cleaner and flatter boned than the hawk today. And the cow just a runaway cow with her frame. She's longer, cleaner, leaner neck, more breed character, femininity about the head, longer body, silkier, more open. She's a wider pin, bigger hip cow. Also a cow that's quite a lot stronger in that pasture and deeper in that hill than the cow in second. The cow in second, another lovely other cow. Both cows, very nice Mammary system. She easily follows over the cow coming out in third. The cow coming out third is just a little heavy in that right front, where this cow's just second cow's a little snugger and smoother in that right four Mannery system. Just has more bloom and pop to the rear udder. Cow just more total cow all the way through in her width of chest, her size, her scale, and her rib. Third cow over the fourth cow, she fits in nicer with the type and kind of the first two here today. Cow that's just a cow has more breed character about that head, has more style and balance, is a smoother top line cow and a freer flowing cow on her hind feet and legs. Third cow's a third calver, a really nice square frame cow. Today she places over the cow coming out next in her overall width and power and her squareness of frame here today. And a cow that I do prefer a little bit nicer on those hind legs. She's a little square tracking from the rear, just more total cow. Red cow's an extremely pretty frame cow, a long-bodied style cow. Like to give her a little more width and giddy up through that front end and just change those hind feet and legs to get her any higher today. Thank you.
In the four-year-old class, the class is sponsored by Bernadale Holsteins and the best udder sponsored by Pure Holsteins. Your class winner, best bred and owned, best udder class, Ring 126, Weeksdale Goldwyn Rally, exhibited by Weeksdale Holsteins. Placing second, Ring 125, Bright Orb Talent Jasmine, exhibited by East River Farms. Placing third, Ring 124, Birkentree Goldwyn Clea, exhibited by Birkentree Holsteins. Placing fourth, Ring 129, Big Maple, Talent, Lorraine, exhibited by Dunphy Holsteins. Placing fifth, Ring 128, Samora Ritzy Coco Red, exhibited by Samuel Fries. Placing 6, ring 130, Weeksdale Allen Molita, exhibited by Weeksdale Holsteins. So once again, the 4-year-old class, sponsored by Bernadale Holsteins. 124 was 3, 125 was 2, 126, best udder in class, best bred known, Weeksdale Goldwyn Rally, your class winner. Ring 127 did not show. Ring 128 was 5, 129 was 4, and ring 130 was 6. Next up, we have the 5-year-olds. So the 5-year-olds will be coming into the ring next. This class sponsored by Big Maple Holsteins, and best udder of the class sponsored by the West Nova Holstein Club.
So it's using that B.
A was sent on.
Yeah, but that says 14 minutes.
It's only here. Yeah. It's up to the launch of the tire, it's A.
Oh. So it's 14 minutes. Okay.
Thank you.
Attention exhibitors, we need your mature cows. The five-year-old class is completed. In their final lineup for the five-year-olds, we need the mature cows at ringside right away. Mature cows, please.
Very close placing here in this mature or five-year-old cow class. I'm going to make the second best udder, or the second cow the best udder. It is close between these two cows in class and in udder. There's some things I like about each cow's mammary system. The second cow is maybe a longer, smoother, four-uddered cow here today, but I prefer the way the size and shape and the way the teats are underneath this first cow's udder, both front and rear, and maybe a little nicer quality to her mammary system today. But the first cow today, her hind feet and legs blow the rest of the class right out of the water. What a tremendous legged cow for a five-year-old cow. And her frame just her dairy strength frame with style just blows away the rest of the class here today. She's just so much longer all the way through than the second cow. She's cleaner in her bone structure through the whole cow, and she's a neater tail-headed cow with so much more balance and style, and just a cleaner cow all the way through. Not that the second cow is not a dairy cow. It's just this first cow is right on the money as far as cleanliness. And I just prefer the bone and the cleanliness of the bone and the hock today and the first cow and the way she travels a lot freer and easier and strength and passion. The second cow, a really wide, powerful, deep front-ended cow, but I like to change her tail head and see her walk a bit smoother and freer on the hind feet and legs. It's been really critical, really fine pair of cows at the top of this class. She handily goes over the third place cow today on her movement. She is a stronger, passionate cow, cow that has more width through her chest and fore rib and spring to her midsection and depth to her midsection. Just overwhelms and outhorses the cow in third. The cow in third over the cow in fourth, she pipes in a lot nicer to the first two cows here today. The cow has more breed character about that head. A cow that's smoother and stronger in that fore udder, smoother and stronger at the top of the rear udder attachment. The big white cow, the dairy cow that's coming out fourth cow, obviously she's in heat, is a fine cow. It's a really good class. There's only four, but four exceptional cows. She just doesn't quite pipe into what I'm looking for today and the three cows I'm ahead of her, but a big square frame dairy cow with a really high front end. I just like to snug her up in the fore udder and the rear udder to find her any higher in this class today. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach Heath. Our five-year-old class, the class sponsored by Big Maple Holstein, test of sponsored by West Nova Holstein Club. Your class winner and best bred and owned in the class, ranked number 131, Wheatsdale Golden Rania, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holstein. Placing second and best udder in the class, ranked 134, ID Golden Lunette, exhibited by ID Holstein. Placing third, ranked 132, Wheatsdale Golden Dallas, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holstein. And placing fourth, ring 133, Roy Ridge Shot of Glory, exhibited by Roy Ridge and Dunphy's Holsteins. If we read down the program once again, the five-year-old class sponsored by Big Maple and best owner sponsored by West Nova Holstein Club. Ring 131 was first and best bred known, Wheatsdale Golden Rania, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holsteins. Placing third was one ring third, 132 was third. 133 was fourth, ring 134 was second and best udder in class, and ring 135 did not show. Currently entering the ring, we will have the mature cow class. So the mature cows are coming into the ring. This class sponsored by Roy Rich Holsteins, and the best bred norm sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. Just a note to exhibitors that following the mature account class, and there is only three entries in the mature account class, following this class, we will have the parade for grand champion. So we would ask the entries in the grand champion parade to start making their way to ringside, please.
They couldn't find one big enough in the same style, so this, because it was a tall, it was a little, but yeah, but like this. I think it has, like, panels versus this as well. They couldn't find one big enough in that, so they had to go to their own dirt factory and buy one. Because I'm Randy Baldwin.
He's a female counterpart.
Long night home, boy.
That's why we have these automatic opening doors.
Who's got the keys?
Fine pair of mature calves here. We have a 7-year-old in first with 5 calves and a 6-year-old with 3 calves. I'm making the best under on this 5th calf and cow. She just the mammary system is higher and tighter all the way through, and is further above the hock than the 2nd cow. I like the strength attachment at the top of the rear udder. Just more youthfulness to the mammary system today. Furthermore, this is a little more my kind of cow. She's got extreme balance, length, squareness of frame, dairiness all the way through. Today, she just has a little more power up through the front end. When you get in front of them, she's wider chested, deeper forward, has more run to that front end. And she has more length to that frame, more quality to the mammary system. But what a lovely cow here in second. She's got that big rib and square cut as well. Just not quite the quality and youthfulness of mammary system as the first cow, but maybe just a touch nicer legged cow, but both really good cows for their age and a fine pair. Thank you.
Thank you.
In our mature cow class, your class winner, Ring 138, Black Avon Talon Alice, given by Greenall Family Farms. And she was also best putter in class. Placing second, Ring 137, Bevo Canyon Iona, exhibited by ID Holsteins. The class sponsored by Roy Rich Holsteins. So that's your mature cow class. Ring 136 did not show, 137 was second, and 138 was first and best putter in class. Next up, we've got the Parade of Champions. Grand Champions sponsored by Green Diamond Equipment. Reserve sponsored by Eastern Dairy Services de Laval. And honorable mentions sponsored by Nova Scotia Animal Breeders. We just do have a momentary break here. Exhibitors, we are looking for the entries for the Parade of Champions for Grand Champions. So we're just waiting on a few cows here as we work towards the conclusion of our show. Just while we have a little lull on the program here, we are going to make one of the special awards of the show. This is the top production cow for the cow that's not just a beautiful looking cow today, but she's also a hard worker back home in the barn. We're going to ask BJ Mayfield with ABS Canada to make his way out over towards the picture area there. And we are going to present the award for top production cow. And this award today is going to go to Weeksdale Goldwyn Rally, ring number 126. So she is the top production award winner. And if somebody from Weeksdale, Blair, or somebody is handy down there, we can make that award presentation. Or possibly is Goldwyn Rally herself there.
After champion. Yeah. So you and Stevens are going to help me place this thing because it's a tie for me.
Audience participation. I love it.
Two adults. Yeah, through the day. They're about the same.
Same in body style?
Everything.
showmanship. They give an adult service.
No. You'll find out when they come in.
Save the tape. Like, who's back in there?
Yeah. Still go to the name you gave me?
Huh?
Still go to the name you gave me or
oh, we're not going to say anything.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Okay.
Who wants to do it after?
Gotcha.
After the class.
Or we can do it now. I don't care whatever y'all want to do.
We've got a panel now, so we're going
to... Panel discussion.
We're going to run with the panel.
Alright. Okay, Grant, what's your count on? 211, I guess. Yeah.
Alrighty. It looks like we're ready to get underway with our parade of champions here at the 2012 Atlantic Theory Championship Show. Leading into the ring, we have our intermediate champion, Lala Van Baxter Fandango from Burnedale Holsteins. Are we ready? Where's our... Next in, we're going to have our reserve intermediate champion. Ring number 95, Nonodale Atwood Knot, by Cransdale P&L and Ponderosa. She will be followed by our honorable mention intermediate champion, ring 102, Big Maple Lulek, exhibited by Dunphy Holsteins. We'll then ask for the first and second place senior three-year-olds. First place, ring 119, combination gold and jewels. Ring 119, combination gold and jewels from Burnedale Farm, our first place senior three-year-old. Our second place senior three-year-old, ring 118, Eastside Duplex Holly from Eastside Holstein. First place, four-year-old, ring number 126, Weeksdale Goldwyn Rally for Weeksdale Holsteins. Followed by our second place, four-year-old, ring 125, Rydor Talon Jasmine, exhibited by East River Farms. Place 5-year-old, Weeksdale Goldwyn Rania, exhibited by Weeksdale Holstein, ring 131. Ring 134, second place 5-year-old, Mighty Goldwyn Lunette, Mighty Holsteins. And then our two mature cows, ring 138, Blackout and Talon Alice, and 137, Bebo Canyon Iona. Once again, this is our parade of champions for the 2012 20th edition of the Atlantic Dairy Championship Show. the Grand Champion Award, sponsored by Cream Diamond Equipment. Reserve Grand Champion, sponsored by Eastern Dairy Services de Laval. And Honorable Mention Grand Champion, sponsored by Nova Scotia Animal Breeders.
What an
incredible cow show. Let's give the exhibitors, breeders, and the fitters, boy, I tell you, whoever got the cattle ready back in the barns, I'm telling you, every one of them come out well today. I think let's give all three of those people a big round of applause. Junior, 3-year-old, just a beautiful udder cow you admire, dairy strength.
52-year-old. Heifer's just going to keep it getting better and better along the more time she has. What a beautiful warm-bodied heifer. 4-year-old, cow has a cranking frame, lots of style. 5-year-old, you just really admire that combination of dairiness and strength. The cow that really pops out at you. 2nd 5-year-old, a lot the same kind of cow. Beautiful long four-rudder. What a set of cows, and let's just get, hey, it's been a good crowd today. Let's give it to them, Mal. Let's give it to them. Not a huge crowd, but I'm telling you, this is a really good crowd. They appreciate the good ones, and they appreciate fine cattle and fine people, and I tell you, the people down here in the East Coast, I've been coming since whenever the bridge opened. I was there the second day. After the bridge opened to go to PEI, and just the friendliest people here in the Maritimes, PEI, Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and great cow people. People like to do a good job, breed great cows, and have a good time. And so it's just a pleasure for me to judge this show. This is the cow that turned me on when she came in the ring. Cow that just possesses that incredible frame, that balance and style. And I'm following her with a 3-year-old, a junior 3-year-old. Just can't get, she'd be my best udder show. I don't know if you had to designate one, but she'd be the best udder show. But she just doesn't quite have that length of frame and that cleanliness of hock and that style and balance of the 4-year-old. And then I think the 5-year-old types in very nicely with the same balance to the frame, the overall length, style, and great legs. Congratulations again. Thank you very much. And the grand champion for your 2012 Atlantic Dairy Championship goes to our first place 4-year-old, Ring 126, Wheatsdale Goldwyn Rally, submitted by Wheatsdale Holsteins. Reserve goes to the intermediate champion, your first place junior 3-year-old, ring 115, Lelevant Baxter Fandango, exhibited by Bernadale Farm. Honorable mention goes to the first place 5-year-old, ring 131, Wheatsdale Goldwyn Rainier, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holsteins. Congratulations to our winners. Thank you to our sponsors, Green Diamond, Eastern Dairy Services, and Nova Scotia Animal Breeders. Next up, we're going to have the Breeders' Herd Class. Breeders' Herd Classes, two into the ring, please. We have the Breeders' Herds into the ring. Don't leave yet, crowd. There's still some excitement. Breeders' Herd.
Lost track.
I'll tell you who it is.
How many? Two?
Oh, there's two.
Yeah.
Could we have Dean Craswell to the show ring, please? Dean Craswell to the show ring, please. Dean Craswell, Brian Craswell, Bruce Wood, if they're still in the barn, we need you all to the show ring, please. So we need Dean Craswell, Brian Craswell, and Bruce Wood, please. In the breeders' herd, two very, very nice breeders' herds. The first group you have... your grand and your honorable mention, and Cal was like third or fourth. And then the next group, you have your reserve grand and two other cows that were right in there banging. Today, you just have more overall balance and style in this first group over the second group. The second group, a very, very nice group, but hard to beat the first one. So, very, very nice. Very nice pair. Thank you. In our breeders' herd class today, your winning exhibit is the exhibit of Weekscale Holsteins, and second, the exhibit of Lelevan Holsteins. We'll ask Weekscale and Lelevan just to hold their herds there while we make the announcements of our awards here for the day. We would, first off, of course, we've recognized our production cow already. Our top show person, the judge and the ringman and a panel of people at ringside fought this one out. It was a very close placing, basically a tie. We were going to get the two participants that were tied out in the middle of the ring to wrestle for it or arm wrestle for it, but that's why we wanted to jump here, Brian. You were the runner-up, I guess. Bruce left on us, so Bruce Wood is going to be show person of the day. Brian Craswell, you're recognized as basically a tie and a runner-up, but they did give the nod to Bruce. Mike wanted to see the wrestling match in the ring, but Bruce left on us. So. Okay, on to our premier breeder and exhibitor of the show. Premier breeder of the show. And we do thank our sponsors, Easton, for these awards, and we're going to get Dale McPhee from Easton to present them. Premier breeder in third place with 62 points, Macbeth Farms. Second place with 81 points, ID Holsteins. And your winner of the Premier Breeder banner this year goes to Weeksdale Holsteins with 101 points. On the Premier Exhibitor side, in third place, also Macbeth Farms with 62 points. There is no second place because we've got a tie for first. Those infamous ties for exhibitor banners, or print banners. So our winner, our premier exhibitor this year, is a tie between Weeksdale Holsteins and ID Holsteins. the last 15, Canuck, and accept that along with Claire. Yeah, maybe they'll wrestle over the banner. That does conclude our show today, folks. It's been a great, great show. We'd like to take the opportunity to thank Mr. Mike Heath from Westminster, Maryland for judging the show today, and for everyone that made the show possible, and the exhibitors for bringing up these great, great cows. Just one last reminder, two exhibitors, Vicki Fletcher is set up in the 4-H barn. Make sure you get your cows out there and get the picture.